Live from the Civic Media Studios at WRCE in Richland Center, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Alba Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Alba. Yeah, freedom.
Good morning across the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming live across the worldwide Civic Media app. I'm Todd Alba. Welcome into the show for a Monday live here from Richland Center, WRCE Studios in the RC, the Driftless area. It is Monday, May 15th, along with a returning from vacation, Mr. Aaron Zommers, our producer and engineer. We welcome you into a Monday morning show from the RC. Mr. Zommers, we missed you. Welcome back.
Missed you guys too. Yeah, good morning.
How was the weekend? Of course, and we have to ask, how was the turkey hunt?
It was a good time. I got to spend some time with my family, and turkey hunting with my dad's always fun. I did get one, got a Jake. Not
really?
Too big, but you can't be too picky when you only get to hunt for a couple days.
Right? I mean, hey, my former boss, Dale Schultz, he had his whole week. You know, he's retired. He got nothing. So, I mean,
yeah, it happens.
I mean, you're doing better than Dale with 2 days.
I had one earlier in that same day on Saturday come up into the woods behind me to the right. And I am right-handed and right-eye dominant, so that is the worst position, because if they're on the left, you can kind of turn and shoot across yourself, but you can't shoot behind you on the right.
no,
and I thought it was going to happen again, and then the turkeys that were there turned around and came out in front. So,
well, you got one. Well, congratulations. That's fantastic. Glad you were successful in the woods. Everything went safely. Had a good time with the family. Got to see Mom, I assume, over the weekend as well.
Spent some time at my grandma's house, and if I sound congested, it's because she has cats.
Well, I sound congested as well, and it's not because I have cats. It's because I'm still dealing with these allergies. I mean, it seems like everybody has allergies right now.
Yeah.
But mine are particularly bad this year. So I have not been smoking cigars all weekend with Mom on the back porch with the J. Edgar Hoover pool boys. It was the plan, by the way. It turns out we had a couple of extra tickets on the Civic Media Brewers ticket supply chain that people could not use. And so Mr. Mathers dialed me up over the weekend and said, hey, we got a couple of tickets. We're going to just eat. Do you want to go? And so I asked Mom, and she said she was all in. And so we called our friends Kurt and Florcy. And so the four of us went down to the Milwaukee Brewers game yesterday. Big win. The Brewers swept the Kansas City Royals over the weekend. Christian Yelich had a big game. A couple of errors by Kansas City, and the Brewers were opportunistic and get the big win. So it was a good time had by all.
Yeah, they did really well, and I saw your video that you posted showing just how nice those seats really are that we give away.
That's really the point in going down there. It's work-related reconnaissance, do you understand? You have to prepare for this, and we want to promote it. But no, here's the really cool thing. And we'll talk more about this after the break when we come back. But the cool thing is, I believe the four tickets that we gave away for our show last week, it was two dads and two sons who came. And the kids, they're young kids, maybe 5 years old or so, I don't know. It was their first Milwaukee Brewer game ever. And so what the dads did is they apparently had brunch or something with the mom for Mother's Day in the morning. And then they took the boys to give Mom the day off for her to just, you know, relax and do whatever. And so they took the kids and they took the boys to their first Milwaukee Brewers baseball game.
Well, that's fun.
I thought that was really cool. So it makes you feel good when these tickets that we're giving away, and again, they're fantastic seats in the club level. And it was great to see a couple of young boys and their dads get to share that on Sunday, courtesy of Civic Media. Don't forget, you can listen to the Brewers baseball games all season long right here on the Brewers Radio Network, on the Civic Media Radio Network, courtesy of WISS. Getting back into it here. I need some more coffee this morning. Oshkosh Air Support, the Big 1100 across the valley on the eastern side of the state, or right here in the RC, WRCE, AM 1450 and FM 107.7 in Richland Center. The Brewers all season long, and you can listen to our show all season as well as many of the other programs across Civic Media as we'll continue to give away these fantastic tickets, these fantastic seats for Milwaukee Brewers baseball. So, yeah, also got to meet my mom, her traditional rhubarb custard pie. Ooh. So got to do that. Yeah, made a little pie. Talked to my sister, wished her a happy Mother's Day. My stepmother, Mary, up in Shawna, wished her a happy Mother's Day. So clicked off all the son and brother boxes. And a little rainy, though, here in Madison. I know Mr. Kreitlow and you were talking this morning, not so much up Lake Wissota, but down here in the Richland Center, Madison, over to Milwaukee, rain all day long.
Well, it's currently not raining here, but...
No, it's right now, right here in Richland Center, beautiful this morning. Picture perfect day. And by the way, Kara Foster will be in at the bottom of the hour with our weather forecast details. Let's get to the couple of the quick checks of weather here in the RC in Richland Center this morning. Expect patchy fog, then mostly sunny skies, a high of 71. I can tell you that most of the fog is lifted, maybe a couple of places in the valley still heading into a little fog. But most of the time here in Richland Center, the fog has lifted, going to a beautiful high of 71 today. Mostly clear skies tonight, a low of 45, and then tomorrow here in Richland Center, sunny, a slight chance of showers and 80 degrees. Wow, beautiful weather right now in southwest Wisconsin. Equally as beautiful up in Wausau, WXCO, Bull Falls Radio this morning. Sunny skies, a high near 72. And for tonight, clear skies, a low of 49. Tomorrow on Tuesday, mostly sunny and a high of 75. Up in Amory, WLAK, Lake Air Radio, patchy fog this morning, then sunny this afternoon, a high near 72 degrees. Then for tonight, clear skies, a low of 51, and tomorrow sunny and a high of 75 degrees. When we come back, our news headlines, what you need to know. Also this morning, talking about Memorial Day, the sales, quote unquote, are beginning already online, on the radio, on TV. Why I think they are an abomination. See what you think. Also, immigration, the big spread for immigration didn't happen. We'll tell you why back after this in the Todd Allball Show. Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It is now 8:15 on the Civic Media Radio Network. Live from Richland Center here in the RC. Happy to be at the WRCE studios. Thanks to Phil Nee, our regional station manager here at WRCE, as well as the entire WRCE, WRCO staff. Always make me feel welcome. Always make me feel at home when I'm back here in the home station. Where it all started, right here at WRCE, WRCO. So happy to be here. Happy to be with you on a Monday. Coming up this half hour, going to talk about a couple of things, border crossings and immigration. A lot of people said when Title 42 ended, it was going to be a huge influx of quote-unquote illegal immigration. And certainly there has been some, several. But it's not this overwhelming tidal wave that Republicans in particular predicted. We'll tell you why this half hour, talk about that. Also talk about why you can't talk about immigration and the problems we face and say it's all one-sided. I mean, certainly in my opinion, the hate, the angst, the anger is coming certainly more from the Republican side than the Democratic side. But both parties are to blame, if you want to be honest, about how and why we got here. We'll talk about that this morning. Also coming up this hour, Memorial Day, the sacred holiday in which we remember those who gave the ultimate sacrifice, is 2 weeks. Can you believe that? 2 weeks away from today, Memorial Day. And the ads have already begun on television, radio, newspapers, online, Memorial Day sales. Why they are an abomination, in my opinion. Talk about that this morning. Also talk a little bit about college graduations over the weekend. Are you boycotting Bud Light? That's something I hear a lot, particularly out around here. People actually boycotting Bud Light. Let us help you out. Because if you're going to do it, you want to be all in. You understand? You don't want to just be halfway. And if you're going to be true to your values, you don't want to just boycott Bud Light. I mean, if you're serious about it, right? You have to boycott Disney, which means also ESPN, which means the NBA playoffs on ESPN, which means college game day on Saturdays, Monday Night Football with the Packers when they are on Monday Night Football. You understand you have to boycott all those things. Otherwise, you're a hypocrite.
And also a whole lot of other beers.
Yes, and a whole lot of beers. So we'll help you. We'll help you. If you're a Bud Light boycott, we'll help you out. We'll help you out while we're on the radio today. And also the Joe Biden informant. Did you hear about this? Republicans had an informant, a whistleblower. They're going to prove that Joe Biden and Hunter Biden were having all these illegal activities. One problem. Whistleblower is nowhere to be found. It can no longer produce said whistleblower. Did you ever think maybe it was because there wasn't one? Just saying. So I'll talk about all those things and more coming up today on today's show. It is now 8:18. Here's what you need to know for a Monday, the 15th of May, 2023. According to the reports from news media this morning, President Joe Biden is expected to meet tomorrow with congressional leaders on the debt ceiling limit following what they're calling productive staff-level negotiations over the weekend as the United States barrels toward a deadline that could come as soon as June 1. Negotiators have been able to pinpoint some areas in which congressional staff and the White House can find common ground, including revising the permitting process, rescinding unspent COVID-19 relief funds, and potentially cutting spending. Biden and the top four congressional leaders, including House Speaker Kevin McCarthy, House Minority Leader Hakeem Jeffries, Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, and Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, held talks on the debt limit last week at the Oval Office. Tomorrow's meeting, which has not yet been officially confirmed, according to the sources, comes after a planned Friday meeting was postponed as the staff-level talks continued. President Biden was interviewed on his bike this weekend as he was doing a little biking, saying that he felt good. The press kind of tried to lure him in, tried to say, get him to say things negative about Republicans. Biden would not bite. Said, look, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay positive. I think there's progress. I think we can get this done. So appreciate his leadership. Again, we're going to talk about this more this hour, but an expected spike in illegal crossings along the U.S.-Mexico border after the termination of the Title 42 pandemic-era migration control policy earlier this week did not materialize in the immediate aftermath of the policy change, according to government data obtained by CBS News. On Friday, the first day since March 2020 in which the U.S. could no longer cite Title 42 to expel migrants, Border Patrol agents apprehended roughly 6,300 migrants, a sharp drop from record levels of illegal entries reported days earlier. A senior U.S. official told CBS News, requesting anonymity by providing unpublished figures. More on that a little bit later this half hour. Overseas now, Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky arrived in the United Kingdom today to meet with Prime Minister Sunak, days after the UK delivered multiple Storm Shadow cruise missiles to Kyiv. The two leaders are set to discuss need for urgent support for the country as Ukraine builds momentum for its highly anticipated counteroffensive against Russian forces. In the coming hours, Sunak will announce a new package of military support for Ukraine that will include hundreds of air defense missiles, Downing Street said in a statement. The UK is the latest stop on Zelensky's tour of Ukraine's European allies. He met with the Italian Prime Minister and Pope Francis in Rome on Saturday. And yesterday, he met with German Chancellor Scholz in Berlin and French President Emmanuel Macron in Paris. Interesting news, Mr. Zomers, in terms of what we're in, media. Vice Media, remember that name? Has filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy today to facilitate a sale of the company and safeguard its future. According to court documents and a statement from the struggling media group, a group of creditors made a conditional bid for substantially all of the company's assets, Vice said. Leaders had agreed to provide approximately $225 million and would assume significant liabilities upon closing of the deal. The plan to sell the company comes less than a month after the end of its popular program, Vice News Tonight. And as news outlets grapple with an evolving media landscape, last week, a major Paramount division said it will shutter MTV News. And a month ago, BuzzFeed announced it would eliminate its news division.
Interesting. I mean, I'm not that surprised because at least the way I always viewed those is BuzzFeed. That's for those dumb clickbait things and fake like quizzes and news. Yeah. Who would trust BuzzFeed for news? And that's the same way I've viewed all of those companies like that. It's just, they can do stuff that's good for social media, getting a lot of clicks. They can do the weird, quirky news that doesn't really matter, but is fun, like pet stories and whatever. But political news or like world news or emergencies or anything, I'm never going to go to BuzzFeed or Vice to find things.
Well, essentially, this story is the popular program Vice News Tonight. I'd never heard of Vice News Tonight, had you?
Me either.
Well, you know, I'm sure somebody who did. They're also shuttering MTV News. I wasn't even aware that MTV News was still on.
I didn't know MTV did anything besides like reality TV and Secret Life of the American Teenager.
You of youth. You of youth.
No, I know they used to. I mean, I didn't know they still did.
No, I mean, back in the day, MTV was it, baby.
It was music TV.
They actually had music TV. They actually had real news. They actually had talk shows. It was quite the thing. You know, times, they are changing. More news now across the country and around the world. Turkey's presidential election appears to be heading to a runoff, as preliminary results showed that the president, Erdogan, had failed to secure a 50% of votes cast to decisively extend his 20-year rule. After millions of people voted and more than 97% of the votes are counted, a state-run news agency reported that Erdogan had 49.34% of the vote compared to 44.99% for his main opponent, meaning that neither could claim an outright win. President Joe Biden is expected to meet tomorrow with congressional leaders, as we said, on the debt ceiling following a productive staff-level negotiations over the weekend. Again, we'll see how that all pans out. And remember, we talked about this last week. The United Nations and other humanitarian organizations are monitoring Cyclone Mocha. Now, I made a little bit of fun of this last week because of the name, Cyclone Mocha. But it is serious. It slammed into Miramar on Sunday, yesterday, with powerful wind gusts of, get this, over 195 miles an hour.
That's
195?
A lot.
The full impact of the storm is not yet known, as officials continue to encounter difficulties contacting people due to downed power lines. However, aid groups warn that early reports suggest the damage is extensive. It was feared that Mocha would hit the Cox's Bazar in Bangladesh, which many consider to be the world's largest refugee camp, but the tropical cyclone made landfall further south. A spokesman for the International Rescue Committee in Bangladesh told CNN it was, quote, a close call for those in that refugee community where about 1 million members live in fragile shelters. Again, always thankful for where we are at. And what we have. And 42 million. That's how many Americans are expected to travel at least 50 miles from home over Memorial Day weekend, according to a new AAA forecast. The holiday, which falls on May 29th, 2 weeks from today, could cause a substantially high level of airport congestion not seen since 2005, according to the report. 42 million people, Mr. Zomers, on the roads, in the air, I should say, for Memorial Day. Are you planning on going anywhere for the weekend?
Not by plane.
Very good.
If anything, I'll probably just go. Well, actually, I think some of my Manitowoc friends were planning to come to Madison this time. So,
well, there. That's even better, right? Let's see. All right, I'm just looking at a couple. By the way, if you're sending me a chat, Mr. Zomers, here we go. I need to open it up there. There we go. Hey, I actually did something with the technology on my own. Can you believe that? I opened up my little chat for my Zoom, and now I can see it. Small steps. So a couple of questions for you this hour. Let's just start with this one, because this is the one that really is on my mind. I mean, we're going to talk about immigration, certainly important. But later on this hour, we're into maybe next hour, we're going to talk about Memorial Day. It's 2 weeks from today. Here's the question for you. Hang on 1 second here, so take a note. So here's the question for you. Memorial Day ads. Are you for them or against them? I'll make it even easier. Do Memorial Day ads make you mad? Do they upset you? Would it make you less likely or more likely to buy from an advertiser that runs a Memorial Day ad? 715-388-7155. Give us a call. 715-388-7155. We'd love to hear from you this morning. Back with more after this. This is the Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. The Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It is now 8:33. A little Lee Greenwood for you on a Monday morning. We are 2 weeks away from Memorial Day. I don't want to say it's one of my favorite holidays, but it's a holiday that has impacted me for many years. So the question this morning is, how do you feel about Memorial Day ads? Whether it's on TV, on radio, wherever it is, newspapers, how do you feel about Memorial Day ads? 715-388-7155. Does it make you less or more likely to buy from a company that runs them? Memorial Day ads, what are your feelings? 715-388-7155. I'll tell you right now, I hate them. I don't use that word too often. I think that Memorial Day ads are the most disrespectful, ridiculous, insensitive thing that a business could possibly do. There are 364 other days of the year to run ads. Look at the calendar. There's International Coffee Day. There's, Take Your Pet to Work Day. Take Your Kid to Work Day. There's all these other things. And yet, we run ads on the day that people get killed and give the ultimate sacrifice for this country, and we have places that want to make money off of that. We'll take your phone calls and discuss it after this. But first of all, something that cannot be controversial is our weather today. Ms. Kara Foster from Weatherology joins us on the weekend after Mother's Day. Kara, this, at least I'm here at Richland Center live today. It's a beautiful day in Southwest Wisconsin.
It truly is, and it's really going to be beautiful no matter where you are today. It's very widespread sunshine. Temperatures are just right today. We're still a little bit warmer than we usually are. We're usually in the upper 60s throughout much of the state, and we're going to be in the lower 70s today. There's not really going to be anything going on, which is really nice for a change, and this will actually continue for much of this week. We will still see some scattered showers, so we were not completely in the clear, but even though we are going to see some rain this week, it's going to be very concentrated to one or two days, and then the rest of the days are just top-notch. So today, sunny and 72 for Amory, sunny and 72 again over in Wausau as well, and also in Richland Center, sunny with a high of 71. There's no winds, nothing else to break that up. It's going to be very, very nice throughout the day. As we head into tonight, we'll stay clear, dip down to about 51 in Amory, clear 49 in Wausau, and clear in 45. So a little bit cooler in Richland Center, just due to there is a cold front that's moving through actually Iowa and Illinois today. So we're kind of getting the outer skirts of that cold front, so just a little bit cooler. But tomorrow, we're seeing just like a dash of rain possible, kind of scattered throughout the state. Very, very small chance. I wouldn't put money down on seeing too much. Temperatures are still going to be in the mid to upper 70s. A lot of sunshine otherwise. Clear skies Tuesday night. We'll see another very beautiful day for Wednesday. Now, we will see temperatures drop slightly, kind of in the mid to upper 60s, but still beautiful day nonetheless. And as we head into Wednesday night, that's when we do see another very slight scattered chance for some showers and thunderstorms. Winds will actually pick up there as well. South winds 15 to 20, gusting as high as 30 Wednesday evening. On Thursday is the main day. We are going to see pretty much I guess not widespread, but a better chance for some showers consistently throughout the state. I would say more so the southern portion, we'll see maybe just some sprinkles, maybe a couple rumbles here and there. And then as you move to the central and northern portions, probably more consistent showers, but you'll still see some sunshine in the morning, highs in the lower 70s. Those south winds, though, will still be kind of continuing. So it's going to be a little bit of a breezier day. Friday, we'll see still some of that kind of lingering, but you'll kind of see a mixture of rain and sunshine, highs in the upper 60s, lower 70s, and then a beautiful weekend, lingering showers early Saturday morning, then sunshine, highs back in the 70s Saturday, and then sunny in the mid-70s throughout the entirety of the state Sunday. So thankfully pretty consistent for this time of year. Nothing too out of the ordinary, nothing severe as of yet, and we won't see, you know, too cold or too warm of temperatures, which is good for this time of year specifically. I'm meteorologist Kara Foster.
All right, Kara, you dialed up a great one. Did you have a nice Mother's Day weekend?
I did. It was a little gloomy over here, so I, you know, didn't go out too much, but was able to just get outside before it started raining, and then kind of just vegged out, which is always kind of a nice weekend activity.
Absolutely. We unexpectedly had a couple of extra Brewers tickets through Civic here, and so ended up taking Mom down to the Brewers game, but it was raining from Richland Center to Madison and Milwaukee, the entire southern part of the state, just lost in some rain and fog and gloom all day yesterday. But again, inside it was beautiful. So that's what counts.
Right, for sure. Yeah, right.
and like I said, today is fantastic. So people can get outside today and do it. Even a 10-minute walk over the lunch hour, right? That's important.
Yes, exactly. These next few days will make up for the time you lost outside over the weekend. So don't worry about
You're fantastic, Kara. We appreciate you. Have a great day.
Thanks, you as well. I'll catch you then.
All right. Yep. Bye-bye. Kara Foster, Weatherology, our meteorologist this morning with a great weather forecast detail. You can listen to Kara each and every morning right here at 8:33 on the Civic Media Radio Network. Talking this half hour about a couple of things. First of all, Memorial Day and Memorial Day ads. Now, the first one I saw, which again, I've been kind of busy. I haven't had the TV on a lot and that sort of thing. So I haven't seen, I see them more on TV than I hear them on radio, but I also hear them on radio. I see them on newspapers all the time. Memorial Day ads. And so the Bob's Furniture, this place is all over. Bob's Furniture. You know, stop down for Bob's Furniture Memorial Day sale. Get 50% off on a mattress. I don't know. Don't go to Bob's and tell them I said that. I don't know. I don't know what their Memorial Day sale is. The point is they shouldn't have one. Or if they're going to have a sale over Memorial Day, just have a sale. Just say, you know, here, we're having a sale this weekend. But don't call it a Memorial Day sale and don't publicize it as a Memorial Day sale. And here's another pro point in the next coming week and a half, 2 weeks. Don't wish people a happy Memorial Day. I feel like I'm doing a George Carlin bit, but I'm not. You know, have a happy Memorial Day. Don't do that. Here, and we'll get more into this as we go, as it gets closer to the day. Memorial Day is not a holiday to be all happy and go lucky about. It's not a holiday to wish someone a happy Memorial Day. It's not a day to use to your advantage if you're a business to sell widgets. And people say, well, we're honoring veterans. No, that's Veterans Day. That's Veterans Day. Comes in November. Great day to honor all the men and women who put on the uniform and serve. That's Veterans Day. 4th of July. Great day to honor our military. People who put on the uniform, keep our country safe, protect our freedoms. Great day. Quite frankly, any day. I was here at Richland Center, went through, had to go to make a forgot a Mucinex back in Madison, had to go to Walmart here. I'll make a little Walmart run. Saw a young man wearing a Marine t-shirt. I said, are you in the Marines? He turns out he's just starting the Marine Corps. I told him, thank you for his service. See, so any day, as it turns out, is a great day to thank the men and women who put on the uniform to protect freedom of this country. Memorial Day is not one of them. Memorial Day was created and it's a solemn holiday. It is a day in which we remember those who died and gave the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. We remember them. We remember them in our memories. We create memorials for them. We go to cemeteries to memorials. It is Memorial Day. It used to be called Decoration Day, when you would go and put flowers on the graves of those who passed. We still do it, not just for military folks, but now for civilians and families and loved ones as well. You remember those who died. You remember those who passed. I mean, think about it this way. Say a friend of yours passed away, a grandparent. Let's say your grandparent passed away. I was fortunate enough to know all four of my grandparents and went to all four of my grandparents' funerals. Helped out with them, was honored to do so. If I owned a business at one point, a coffee shop, what would you have thought if I would have said, come on down to Fifth Element Coffee. We're giving away 10% on every drink due to my grandfather's passing. My grandfather's funeral is on Friday. Stop on down for 10% off for a Warren Wallace Memorial Coffee Sale. People would have said, you're crazy. You're an insensitive SOB. And they would have been absolutely right. But yet that's what businesses do each and every year. And here's the really insensitive part. What do you think that does for the spouses, the men and women, the kids who have lost loved ones in a line of duty? To turn on the TVs, the radios, to open the newspapers, to go online and see that on the day in which it's supposed to be set aside for the memory of their loved one, the day on which it brings back to their front of their mind the day they got the tragic news that their loved one was killed in action or succumbed to injuries, was lost in a war, a conflict, a military action, whose body either lies in state in Arlington National Cemetery in Washington, D.C., or at a local cemetery, or the Tomb of the Unknown, or perhaps was lost in battle and the body was never recovered, missing in action. And they live with that each and every day. They live with that 365 days a year. And all they want, all they're asking for, is one day, Memorial Day, in which we set aside and say, regardless of whatever party we belong to, Republican, Democrat, Independent, nothing, that we should all be able to come together without partisanship and focus on the fact that men and women died so that we can go about our lives every day. We can go to Walmart, we can go to the park, we can go to a Brewers game and think nothing of it. We think nothing of it too often. But the thing is that people gave their lives so that we could do these things that we say are mundane and simplistic and just a part of our daily ritual. Someone paid a price for that. A lot of someone's, millions of someone's paid a price for that. And we set aside Memorial Day each and every year to remember them. So just stop it if you're a business. Just stop trying to take advantage of that holiday to make money on your mattresses and your cars and your curtains and whatever you're trying to sell. You can afford to take one day off, all right? Just one. Because as it turns out, the men and women who put on the uniform don't take any days off, including Memorial Day. They're still standing guard around the world, around this country, at military bases all over. They're still training to protect us. So just stop with the ads. What do you think? 715-388-7155. Again, area code 715-388-7155. We'd love to hear from you. Memorial Day ads, does it make you less or more likely to go there? We'd love to hear from you this morning. Also, we're going to come back either yet this hour or perhaps next. We're going to take a look at the spike in illegal immigration that did not happen and explain a little bit, perhaps, why it did not happen. A great report from CBS News on that. And, of course, much, much more. Stay with us. This is the Todd Allball Show, live from Richland Center, WRCE, on the Civic Media Radio Network. The Todd Allball Show, Pacific Media Radio Network. It is now 8:50 on the Mix program. Glad to have you with us live in the RC, WRCE, AM 1450, FM 107.7, and on WXCO in Wausau, WLAK in Amory, and streaming worldwide on the Pacific Media app, along with our producer and engineer. I'm Todd Allball. Glad to have you along. Mr. Zomerich, you'll find this interesting. I mentioned it to you earlier in the show. Maybe our listeners will as well. So as you know, over the course of this program, the last 6 months, we've had a little fun and some seriousness as well with our state senator from this area, Howard Markline, and one of our state representatives, Todd Novak from Dodgeville. Of course, Howard Markline, the chairman of the Joint Committee on Finance in Madison, and represents this area. Todd Novak represents a couple of townships in southeast Richland County, and is from Dodgeville, also the mayor down there in Dodgeville. And I've been very upset, particularly at Howard, for not showing up in Richland Center when it comes to the closing of the UW Richland campus, among other things. And of course, I invited he and State Representative Tony Kurtz on this program, so I'd give them as much time as they wanted. I'd ask him pointed questions, but I would give them as much time as they wanted if they wanted to come on the program. Said that to their face and invited them in all sincerity to their face. And the response I got back from Senator Markline was, quote, "I'll think about it. I'll think about it." So as it turns out, this morning, I'm here at Richland Center live to do our show in the WRCE studios. And just down the hall, I found out State Senator Howard Markline and State Representative Todd Novak are going to be here in the building to go on our friend Phil Nee's show, the morning show, on WRCO FM 100.9 at just after 9 o'clock. So we are going to be here in the same building in Richland Center. So my question is, what should I pull, like a Mike Wallace? Should I walk down the hallway with a microphone and say, "Senator, you're here on the other show. What do you have to say about this?" Should I do like an ambush interview this morning? Would that be too much?
I don't know. I don't know how much. Well, I guess it doesn't matter how much they like it. It's how much it's appropriate. I don't know the answer to that.
Or maybe we should carry the morning show, Phil Nee's show on the FM site. Maybe we should carry that, simulcast it live on our show, and then we could fact check Howard and Todd in real time. That might be kind of fun. Out of respect to my longtime friend and colleague, Philip Nee, I said, no, I will behave myself. I will, because I didn't really, so we decided to do the show here over the weekend because I was going to be up here anyway. And I found out over the weekend that Senator Howard Markline and Todd Novak were going to be here. I said, no, I'll behave myself. I'm not going to do an ambush interview. But I see him in the hallway. I could see him in the hallway and say, I'm going to, and if they're listening now, come on down. As I said, the price is right. Come, it's just down the hall to our little studio here. Yeah. Which is essentially the conference room.
Yeah, I was going to say that. I feel like it is very fair to hop out, and I think it'd be polite, too, to be like, hey, we are here. Just remember, you have this this open space to talk and say your piece if you want. We're not going to make fun of you. We're not going to
yell
at you.
I've said before, I've said before, if Senator Howard Markline, if Representative Tony Kurtz, if Representative Todd Novak, Representative Travis Trennell, or any of the Republican legislators in this area of the state or anywhere want to come on our show, I will give them, we have 3 hours every day. We'll give them as much time as they want to say their piece. Now, will I also then ask pointed questions of them Sure, absolutely. Will I be disrespectful? No. But I will ask questions.
And then if they're too busy, with air quotes or not, that's okay.
But I thought that was fabulous when I heard that Howard and Todd were going to be here today. I thought, wouldn't that be fantastic? I said, like Mike Wallace, well, Senator, we haven't seen you in quite a while. Would you like to come on down the hall? We have a lot of questions to ask you. Oh, the fun of games, they never stop. Issue number two this morning after Memorial Day is illegal immigration. And we're going to be talking about this next hour. And I'm not sure, Mr. Zomers, what do you think? Should we play the cut from CBS News now, or should we wait until after the break?
Let's do it.
All right. So this is a story, great story to summarize this whole issue on illegal, quote unquote, illegal immigration. This appeared on the CBS Evening News last night with Jerika Duncan. Let's play the story, and we'll come back and discuss it.
Tonight, many of the migrants stuck in Mexico were trying to get into the U.S. with the assumption they would be let in after the asylum rule changed. Well, as you can imagine, that misinformation caused confusion. CBS's Nicole Skanga is in the border community of Brownsville, Texas. Nicole, what more are you learning about the number of migrants crossing right now?
Good evening, Jerika. Over the past 2 days, U.S. Border Patrol says there's been roughly a 50% drop in migrants arriving at the southern border compared to earlier this week. A waiting game, now a humanitarian crisis. Tiny faces peer through a San Diego border wall, hands outstretched for anything to eat.
Hambre también, tenemos mucha hambre.
You're hungry.
Hungry, yes.
Migrants also clutch their phones for a ticket out. 40-year-old Manuel Sanchez says he's been trying and failing to secure an immigration appointment on the U.S. government's online portal.
Yo particularmente, no sé, muchas personas le he preguntado a más de 60 venezolanos y nos vamos a regresar a esa tierra.
Stuck in purgatory, the Venezuelan migrant adds he may turn back. For those who made it to America, some are exhausted and penniless, like 32-year-old Venezuelan Victor Blanco, who lost nearly everything while swimming across a river in Colombia.
Bueno, pasar por muchas cosas. Vine luchando por allá, poco a poco caminando, agarrando bus por la selva.
He says he's been through a lot and now waits, among many others, at a Brownsville, Texas bus station to start his new life in the U.S. Others remain at overcrowded migrant processing centers.
We are holding about 5,000 people. My capacity is about 4,600.
Border communities stuck between competing asylum policies and squarely in the middle of immigration politics.
This is not a Democratic or Republican problem. It's an American problem.
And just across the Rio Grande River behind me, beyond this border wall, migrant tents lining this crossing, Mexico has announced it won't admit more than 1,000 migrants a day from those expelled by the U.S. Jerika?
Causing, I'm sure, even more confusion. Nicole Skanga, who's been reporting from Brownsville all week for us on those very important stories. Thank you.
There you have it. Great reporting from Nicole Skanga from CBS News, and as reported last night on CBS Evening News with Jerika Duncan. The important line here that I want to focus on, we're going to do this next hour and take your calls as well. A 50% drop in so-called illegal immigration as compared with earlier last week. A 50% drop. The big scare that now that Title 42, the Trump-era policy ended, that we're going to have this big rush, didn't materialize. All a bunch of hooey. Why both Republicans and Democrats are responsible for the position we're in. That, your phone calls, much, much more next hour. Stay with us. This is the Todd Allball Show, and this is the Civic Media Radio Network.